drive. But I appreciate the Lord this morning and just how good that he's been to me. And I feel like, and I know that everybody says this, but I feel like that he's been better to me than he has been anybody else. I feel like he's just, I'm the only lamb that he's got. And I'm so glad of just his promises, how good that he's been. But if you've got your Bibles and your cards, you'd like to turn with me, I'll be in Luke chapter 20. Let's try to get to what the Lord laid on my heart. And I know in the sinful church I'll be talking. That the prophet in my flesh was no good thing. And I know that that's the way all of us are. But I'm glad, when the Lord comes by, God, amen, just hold us. Just let. God use it for his glory. Not my glory, nobody else's. But God is able to use it. Amen. If we'll just let him. Luke chapter 20 and verse number 17. Y'all pray for me. And the Bible said, and he beheld them and said, what is it? What is this then that is written? The stone which the builders rejected, the same is become the head of the corner. Whosoever shall fall upon that stone shall be broken. But on whomsoever it shall fall, it will grind him to powder. That's all I'm going to read. Let us pray one more time. Dear Heavenly Father, God, we come before you, Lord, one more time this morning, God. And I pray, Lord, that you would just, Lord, just take this word that we've read, God, that, Lord, that you'd let it, God, just find a hiding place down in our hearts. And God, that we might hide it. God, that we might not sin against thee. And Lord, I pray that you'd just anoint me. God, hide me. I'm behind the cross, oh Lord. And God, that you might receive all glory. And God, that you might receive all praise. And God, I don't know who might hear. I got the word this morning, oh Lord. I pray that I got it for somebody out there. I got it maybe in sin, Lord, of dying. Lord, going to hell. I pray that, Father, that you'd convict them, Lord, right where they're at. Oh God, that you'd pull them out of their sin, Lord, that you'd save them, God, right now. And we ask it all in the name. That's above every name, in the name of Jesus Christ. And amen. Now, as the blood that the Lord has laid on my heart, and it was the stone that brought me, and by the help of the good Lord, that's what I would preach to you about this day. And I think about how I prayed that when I was younger, maybe I stood something down there, Brother Tim, that I should not do. I could have maybe hear, and then maybe my dad say, boy, I'm going to break you from that. I'll break you. And then from what you're doing, and what I found one day, and the bread of the Bible said, and that the stone which the builders have rejected as now have become the head of the corner. And well, who is that stone? And why it's the Lord and Lamb of God. And then the Lord have the root, the offspring of David, have the bride and the morning star. And brother, the Bible said that he came to his own, and his own received him not. That to as many as would receive him. And you know who that is. I pray that's me. I received him down in my heart. And he said to as many as would receive him, and to them gave he power, and to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. Well, who have you got your trust in? I've been not aided no man, and not aided myself. But brother, I've got my trust in the Lord of heaven, and the one that became flesh, and that it condemned sin in the flesh, and now he became sin, he that knew no sin, and that I might be made, and the righteousness of God in him. Oh yes, I had no righteousness about me, and but when God on the road of sinful flesh, I put righteousness on me. Isaiah said, and then that we, and then we're all as filthy rags. Our righteousness was, and but one day I put on a robe that's white. And one day I put on a robe, amen. And that God, and then we're washed with his own blood. And that God, and then said there ain't no spot. And there ain't no blemish. Well, there wasn't no spot in him, and there wasn't no blemish in him. Oh, yes, I was living a life of sin. I was living a life, and it's going to take me to hell. And then one day, and the stone that the builders, I said, God, it broke me from my sin. He broke me from my ungodliness. He broke me from the life I was living. He changed me. firm ground. But the Bible said that God, he resisteth the proud, but he giveth grace to the humble. And then the Bible said six things that the Lord hate. The Lord hate things, and he don't hate people, Brother Tim, but he hates sin, don't he? And then six things that the Lord hate, and yea, seven, and the Lord abomination, and then he said pride. God hates pride, but God said if you'll fall on this stone, and then yes, it'll break you, but after he breaks you, he'll put you back together again. And God told Jeremiah, he said, go down to the potter's house, and let me show you something there. And he went down there, and he said, I saw, down there in the potter's house, he said, I see the vessel, and that was so hard. He said, but the potter said, I'll just swap it all away, and I'll start over again. I went one March morning, about 7 years ago, and brother, I got a new slave, and then God walked away, and then all the old sin, and God walked away, and then all of my past, and then where's it at now? Well, the east and the west, I brother, they never meet. But God said he took my sin and cast it as far as the east is from the west. And then I'll never see their old sin no more. But where am I bringing up on you, child of God? But God, I said, I'll never remember them things you used to do. But aren't you glad that one day you can look back in your mind and you say, that's the day that I fell on the stone. That's the day that I fell on Jesus. But if I have one thing to tell you, I'd say just fall on Jesus right now. I'd just fall on him. But he'll break you. But he'll make you whole again. Amen. The Bible said, amen, that all throughout time, that from the time the children of Israel, brother, from the time they come out of Egypt, and then they come out and they wandered in the land of Canaan, the wilderness there, waiting to go over in the land of Canaan, and then there's always a murmur, and then God brought them over, and God, amen, he made them a nation there, a mighty a nation there, and he said, and that one day, because of your sin, I'm going to bring a man named Nebuchadnezzar, and then down here, and he's going to lead you away. And now that man was a proud man. That man was a man. And then only thought about himself. And then he said, now here I am, I'm a king. And I've done all this under me. And then I've done all this for myself. I've done all this amen, for me. And then I've done it with my hands. Done it with my mind. Well, people right now are today, they say, I've done this myself. I've done that myself. I've done it with my hands. I've made my living. But I've done, man, I've worked my hands to the bone, my fingers to the bone. I've worked and done this, they might say. Well, brother, I've done that since. I don't know that I ain't done nothing myself. That everything that I've had, that I have, God, he's given to me. The Bible said that James has said every good and perfect gift cometh from above and from the Father of lights, and whom there is no marvelous and neither shadow of turning. And so when you got up this day and you're able to put your feet on the ground, and God give you that, and that money you got in your bank account, and then God give you that, oh yes, it's time we look up and see that we ain't done nothing for ourselves. And God, he's done it all. And the one that drove me supplies my every need. And the one that drove me and made me whole again, and now walks with me, and now talks with me, and now every word that my feet shall trod, who's right there with you? And God, he's been right there through it all. As the old song says, I've learned to trust in Jesus. I've learned to trust in God. I found that the one that broke me that day hadn't been leading me down there in sin. But he's been so good to me. I'm telling you, that amen, I've met nobody no better. I've met nobody that done me like Jesus. Oh, yes. But if you need him right now,
children of Israel, and that they would have been out establishing their own righteousness. And that's where people's at right now. But you see, I have none. Amen. A good sister, a good brother, you have none. Amen. But God gave you what you got. And if you live right now, it's because that God lives in you. And you say, I can't live it, that's because God don't live in you. But if you'll just let God live through you, Paul said, nevertheless I live, and yet not I, but Christ I liveth in me, who lives in you. Amen. Jesus I lift down in my soul. Oh, we ought to be the happiest people, amen, that's ever walked this land. And because we got a King that lives in our hearts. Oh yes, I'm the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Amen. He don't just put up in the heavens of heaven, but he dwells inside of me, just so fresh and touched. Amen. Amen. They said, Nebuchadnezzar, how the old proud man. Amen. I've done everything myself. Amen. Don't that sound like the way it is right now? I've done everything myself. Amen. Most of your politicians, they've done everything themselves. Amen. They've done this for you, and they ain't done that for you. Amen. But they don't realize that the God of heaven is the one that give them breath. It's in Him that we live, move, and have our being. It's in Him, amen, that we do everything. And so the Bible said that Nebuchadnezzar, that brother, he come down there and he, amen, he led children of Israel into a strange land. How, well, brother, I'm in a strange land. Amen. Seeing on every hand, I see it on every corner. Amen. We're in a strange land. Amen. But you know what Jesus said? He said, when you see all these things, I begin to come to pass. Now just look up and lift up your head. For your redemption, after all, now we're in a strange land. But brother, one day we're going to the land that I call home. One day we're going to the land where everything's right, where everything's perfect, where there's no more death, where there's no more sickness. One day we're going to the land where the soul of man never shall die. Don't that sound good? I'll tell you what it sounds like. It sounds like my home. Brother, I'm not a citizen down here, but my citizenship, it's up yonder. Somewhere I can't see, somewhere I've never seen, but by the eye of faith, I see that land. I see that land. One will live forever. I see that land. Amen. Where I'm going to sit down with the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings and serve Him forevermore while the ages roll on. Amen. This world ain't my home. Amen. It ain't. Amen. So we've got so many up the strength, strokes, and deep there. Amen. They don't want to leave. But I'm telling you, the more, amen, the more they die. Amen. I've been saved for over 7 years. And the farther I go with the Lord, Freddy, I realize that I don't want this world. Amen. This world ain't got nothing for me. Amen. All the world's got is sin. All the world's got is sickness. All the world's got is, amen, there ain't no hope in the world. Ain't nothing but sadness. Ain't nothing but things to bring you down. But I read one day that the sorrow, amen, God, the sorrow lives me into repentance. But the sorrow of the world, brother, it won't get dead. But one day I got sorry for how I was living. One day Jesus said, I'm going to break you from how you are living. One day Jesus said, just come unto me and follow me. And when I break you, I'll do a work that no man can hinder. Some might say, I'll clean myself up. You might do it for a little while. Jesus will do a work that no man can hinder today. Amen. So, amen, pride, pride, pride. That's what Nebuchadnezzar had. Amen. But God used him. Amen. To come in there and do, amen, what judgment on the children of Israel. But after he did that, amen, he said one day, he said, I had a dream. And he said, I seen, amen, a tree that grown up. Amen. A big old, amen, a big tree. And all the birds of the air come and rested in it. Amen. But he said, there, he said, now here come a watcher. And the watcher hewn down the tree. Amen. He said, but now wait a minute. I leave the root in the ground. I don't pull the root out of the ground. I say, Yes, another amen. I'm going to go down there and find Daniel. I'm going to find that man of God. I'm going to find that one that told me how what my dream was before. And surely he can tell me what this means. And so he said, Daniel, what's this dream mean? What's all this mean? And then he said, all right, king. And now you've got a kingdom. And then the birds and everything, amen, they rest in it. All the nations of this world, how king, they rest under your hand. He said, but let me tell you one thing, how that God's going to cut you down. Amen. You know what God says right now? Amen. You tell the, amen, you tell the adulterer, and you tell the fornicator, and you tell the liar, and you tell them that do wrong to the neighbor, and you tell that one that cheats, and you tell that one, amen, how that drinks the booze. How you tell them how that God's going to cut them down. How God, amen, is going to cut your world one day. God is going, amen, to set judgment. And when judgment is said, brother, when judgment is cast, how there'll be no getting right. How there'll be no change in your mind. Amen, when the tree falls, that's how it's going to be. Amen, Daniel said, God is going to break you down, king. Now let me tell you, friend, if you're proud right now, God is going to bring you down. Amen. God's going to bring this world down one day. Amen. All the proud and all the boastful, God's going to bring them down one day. Amen. It said, king, you've got this great tree. Amen. It said, amen, and all the birds and all the fowls, they rest in him, but God said he's going to cut you down. Amen. So the Bible said that Nebuchadnezzar, amen, that after this happened, that all these things came to pass. And it said that Nebuchadnezzar had began to eat grass as the oxen fed it. And it said that Nebuchadnezzar had that his hair grew out like eagle's feathers. And that his, amen, it says nails had grew out like bird's claws. Amen. And you know what happened to him? How God brought judgment on him. How God said, I'm going to break you. But we read about another image. Amen. Before all of this, amen, he said, now, amen, when Daniel come in there and told him, amen, what his dream was. Amen. He said, I saw this image. And he said, brother, up on the mountain. Amen. Where your image was down there in the valley. Amen. He said, I seen a rock. I seen a stone. How they would shoot out of the mountain without hands. And it come rolling down. And it crushed your image in pieces. Amen. You know what happened to me one day? I seen a stone. How they shoot out of the mountain without hands. And it came down and broke my ambition. And it came down and broke all my pride. Amen. Oh, yes. Amen. He broke me right to where I was. And now, you know where I'm at. How that same stone that I fell on, I'm rooted on this stone. Amen. Oh, yes, I've slipped. Oh, yes, I felt the wind. But I found, he said, he that builds his house on this stone, and the wind might come, and the rain might come, and the storms might come, and the Paul said, be a steadfast, unmovable, always above me in the work of the Lord. I want to be steadfast on this rock where I stand. Amen. He said, that stone come out, and it broke up his image. But Nebuchadnezzar come down. Amen. Lay there. Amen. Out there in the grave, amen, eating grass. That's crazy, ain't it? That's crazy. Amen. For a man, we'd see that, we'd have him admit it. Amen. Our day and time. Amen. But you know what's happening? Amen. That, amen. People say, amen, they got, amen, they got this wrong with them, got that wrong with them. I know what's wrong with people right now. I believe that, amen, God is just withdrew his hand. Amen. You know why there's men with men? Amen. Women with women in our time. God's withdrew his hand. Amen. You know what? Amen. Ain't nothing wrong with shacking up no more. God's withdrew, amen. He said, I'm going to turn them over. Amen. To a reprobate mind. But you know what Nebuchadnezzar come down to? He come down to have a choice. The stone had done broke down his image. But here he had a choice. Amen. He said, I can fall on Jesus, or I can let that stone fall on me. And now the Bible said, if you fall on that stone, that you'll be broken. And that sounds like a bad thing. But you see, God can put you back together again. But he said, if that stone falls on you, he'll grind you to powder. And brother, once you're ground to powder, but it's over with, how you'll burn forevermore. How you see, we've got a choice today. How we can fall on Jesus, or one day, how the stones will fall on us. Amen. Nebuchadnezzar come down. We had two choices. Amen. He said, I've done lost everything. Amen. I'm out here crazy. Amen. But he come to himself. Bible said there's a, amen, a prodigal one day. Bible said that, amen, he lived there and he had everything that he ever wanted, Brother Tim. Amen. He said, all right, Daddy, I heard it right now. And he went there to, amen, the strange land, the far country. Amen. Amen. Maybe you got kids out there right now. Maybe you got grandkids out there right now in a strange land. Amen. But get up, the Bible said, it said he got down there. And he said, I fain would have filled my belly with the husk that the swine did eat. He didn't even get to. He just wanted. Amen. He said, if I could just, amen, if I could just take of the, amen, the husk that they're eating. Amen, I can't even have him. Amen. The Bible said that he came to himself. And he said, I know what I'll do. Amen. I know what I'll do. I'll go back. I'll rise up out of my sin. Hallelujah. And I'll go back to the Father's house. Amen. So here he come. Amen. The Father out there looking. Amen. Where's my boy at? Where's my boy at? Amen. I ain't seen him in years. Amen. Here he comes. I see somebody out there on the road, he said. Amen. He said, go kill the guy. Amen. Give him a ring and the very best robe. Amen. My son. Amen. He was dead, but now he's alive. He was lost, but now he's found. How you know what the old prodigal did that day? He said, I'm tired. I lay it under that stone. I'm just going to fall on it and let it break me. And then Daddy will make everything all right. Amen. I'm glad the Father one day made everything all right for me. Amen. So he said, I'll just go back. You know what he had to do? He had to be broken. Go back to Daddy's house. That was a shameful walk up that road, brother. That was a shameful walk back to Daddy's house. That was a shameful, amen. Oh, he went out in pride, and he went back with his head held hung low. He went out boastful, and he went back with no boasting in him. He went out saying, I've got everything I need. And he went back saying, I don't have anything. Amen, I've not got anything. But you know, the Bible said that they went out when they sat there in the wilderness, that their clothes never waxed so long. Amen, their shoes never wore out. Amen, you know why? Because the God that we serve, our brother, he's able to sustain. The God that we serve, he's able to take care of us. Amen, no matter what the world might throw at you. Oh, yes, if you've been broken by that stone, you know what I'm talking about. If you've been broken by that stone, you know what God can do for you. Amen. So never can do choices, just like a prodigal. How it was, it's like there's no hope for it. Amen. His hair grew out. Amen. Eating grass. What man, this will lock him up, they might say. Ain't no hope for him. Well, where was you at? Where was I at? No hope for me. Amen. No hope. Dying and going to hell. Amen. But you know why I seen him walking down my road one day? Amen. Oh, yeah. Amen. Who'd you see? Amen. I seen that man out of Galilee. I seen Jesus of Nazareth walking down my dusty road. He come down to Scott County, Virginia. Amen. To save a wretch like me. Amazing grace. How sweet the sound. Amen. Saved a wretch like me. I once was lost. Amen. Now I'm found. Oh, yes, I was blind. Amen. When Jesus come to me one day, he put the mud on my spiritual eyes. And he said, go wash down yonder in the pool. I get all I washed in. It wasn't the pool of Siloam. But I washed in the living water. And it made me whole. And give sight to my blinded eyes. Amen. I fell on him. And he made me whole. Amen. I was just broken. I had to be broken. Amen. I had to be broken. I had to be broken in my pride. You know what the world needs? They need to go to Daddy and say, I'm going to break you, son. I'm going to break you. Amen. Some of y'all remember that. Amen. I'm going to break you. You know what God did to me one day? He broke me. He broke me. Amen. You know, people have hurt your feelings. People, they'll let you down. Amen. And they'll break you. People might break your heart. Amen. You get put confidence in them. They let you down. Or, amen. They treat you wrong. I remember when Jesus broke me, he didn't leave me like that. When Jesus broke me, he didn't let me wallow around. People's are wallowing around in their pity. Amen. Want somebody to have pity on them. Amen. Wallowing around their self-pity. Amen. Brother, amen. God don't have pity on sin. Amen. He says, I'll break you. Amen. I'll make you whole. God didn't save us to live in sin. Amen. God said, if you'll call on me, if you'll fall on this stone, I'll break you. Amen. Then I'll put you on the stone. Amen. I'll make you, amen, a fit subject. I'm glad I've been made a fit subject for the kingdom of heaven today. Hallelujah. Bible said that Daniel come down out of Nebuchadnezzar. Nebuchadnezzar looked up one day, book 10. He said, here's my choices. Amen. I'm broken. I was a king. Amen. That had everything. See, the kingdoms of this world, they think you got everything. But I look out to them on them rolling hills. And you know who owns that? Bible said my father. Amen. He owns the cattle on 1,000 hills. Amen. Amen. The kingdoms of this world ain't got nothing. Amen. The presidents and the prime ministers and all that, they ain't got nothing. Amen. But God, he owns everything. Amen. Oh, yes, he does. He owns it all. And the God that owns everything, and the God that formed the whole world, has said, if you'll fall on this stone, and you'll be broken, and then I'll make you whole again. Amen. If you're here today and you ain't right, I want you to know God. Amen. You might be broken. You might be. But God wants to make you whole. Nebuchadnezzar was broken. But you know what happened if he'd stayed where he was? That stone was just looking over his head. Amen. It's about to crush him. And about to grind him to powder. Amen. And when he was ground to powder and he died, it'd be over with. Amen. But he said, I've got another choice. I've got another option. Jesus said, I'll liken the kingdom of heaven to a man, to, amen, to two men and build a house. One bit on the sand, and the winds come and wash that sand out from under the house. There wasn't no foundation. You know what's wrong with the, amen, what's wrong with the kids now? Amen. My generation, the one under me, amen. They don't see nothing wrong with anything. They ain't got no foundation. Amen. They're being taught a bunch of garbage in school. Amen. We come from monkeys. They ain't got no foundation. Amen. They're being taught everything's all right at home. Amen. Every man's right in his own eyes. But brother, you know where the law comes from? It comes from the lawgiver. Amen. You know where living right comes from? It comes out of the Word of God. And you know where the foundation comes from? It comes from the stone that the builders rejected. The stone that broke me. That's where it comes from. He said, but there's another man that built on a sure foundation. Paul said, if you build on anything other than that which has been laid, it's going to, amen, wood, hay, and stubble will all burn up. But if you'll build on the rock, the fire will come, and it'll be all right. Amen. When the fire comes, it'll be all right. When death comes, it'll be all right. When sickness comes, it'll be all right. Why, preacher? Because the stone that broke me made me whole again. Amen. I've got two choices. Nebuchadnezzar can say, I can stay out here broken. Amen. But he said, no. He said, that God that Daniel told me about, he said, I realize now that he is the God of heaven. He said, that God that Daniel, amen, worshiped and prayed, that God that them three Hebrew boys, what, amen, they wouldn't bow down to me because they loved their God so much. He said, that God, that's the God, that's the true and living God. Bible said it's a fearful thing to fall in the hands of the living God. So he said, all right. He said, the rest of my days, I'm going to extol, lift up the God of heaven. You know what God did for me? When he put me up out of sin, he put something in me that I said, the rest of my days, Brother Tim, the rest of my days, amen, if I live to be 120 years old, the rest of my days, I'm going to lift, by the grace of God, I'm going to lift up the, amen, the name of the only, amen, the only God, the true living God, the one that gave his only begotten Son, that I might be broken and made whole again. Amen. You're going to have to be broken before you ever be made whole. Amen. I trust that everybody here is saved. But if you ain't, I want you to know that God said the stone which the builders rejected has now become the head of the corner. And he said, if any man will fall on this stone, he shall be broken. Well, that sound, that ain't nothing no man wants to do, to be broken. But amen, there's only two choices. You can fall on it and be broken, or the stone can fall on you and be ground to powder. I was out and I'm closing. I was helping my buddy dig a trench to lay some water line in the other day, and there was this rock everywhere. Some of them rocks, amen, that's huge. I thought it best to pile on, and best to pile on your foot or something like that, and that's liable to break it. Amen, that's what Jesus is. Amen, he said that the kingdom of heaven is like a little tiny mustard seed. It's a small seed, but when you plant it in the ground and it grows, amen, all the powers of the air, Lord. See, Nebuchadnezzar said, but all the birds are lost in me. Amen, but he didn't know that there's another kingdom going to be set up. Amen, there's another kingdom going to be set up in the heart of men. Amen, that everything will be under his feet. One day God's going to put everything under Jesus' feet, and it'll all wrap up, and it'll be over with. And we'll go on. There'll be with Jesus forevermore.